Well, from Jolene to I Will Always Love You, Dolly Parton knows how to write a song that stays in our hearts. But now she's teaming up with a writer of a different kind, James Patterson, one of the world's most prolific authors. Their co-written novel is about a young country singer faced with the tough reality of the music game. Our CBS colleague Lee Cowan asked them about it.
The old river running through my town.
The Bluebird Cafe in Nashville is home to some of the best short story writers around. After all, story is what makes a great country song. And every writer,
here's to you,
especially acclaimed ones like novelist James Patterson, know just how hard that can be.
I actually tried to write some country and western songs, you know, knock 'em, sock 'em kind of love songs.
Did you ever perform them?
No.
That's because, in part, Patterson was too busy becoming a novelist. He's written or co-written more than 200 of them, and he has more bestsellers than anyone. He's at home in Music City. He earned his master's from Vanderbilt University, and he's never forgotten the faces of wannabe country stars wandering from bar to bar.
You could not sit in one of those bars for more than 10 minutes without somebody coming in off the street, sitting down and playing.
For his latest novel, Patterson decided to write about a nobody coming to Nashville with dreams of becoming a somebody. Even he admits that's a tale as well-worn as an old pickup, which is why he needed a co-writer who would actually live that life to give the book a little sparkle.
I asked him, I said, why do you need me? You're doing pretty good on your own.
She said he's that guy that writes about serial killers, right?
Yeah, I knew that.
Yep. The legendary Dolly Parton.
Jolene, 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 Jolene.
It might seem an odd pairing at first, the girl from the Great Smoky Mountains of East Tennessee,
here you come again,
who became one of the queens of country music, teaming up with a former Manhattan ad executive turned bookworm who's barely touched a guitar in his life. They hadn't even met until 2019. When Patterson flew to Nashville to pitch Dolly on the idea.
And you'd even go pick him up at the airport sometimes.
Yeah? I'm always there to pick him up. I wouldn't dream of letting him come into town.
That's so sweet.
But that's what you do out of respect. But I just ain't going to send somebody after him if I can at all be there.
I mean, if you guys hadn't clicked and not particularly liked each other, would it have worked?
It wouldn't have happened, no.
No, we didn't have to do it.
Yeah.
I don't make that many friends. And a lot of my old friends have gone on. And I've got some friends. You don't always trust them after you get famous. You don't know who's a friend and who's not.
Their collaboration is called Run, Rose, Run, the story of a young country singer named Annie Lee who comes to Nashville only to find that the music industry can be just as heartbreaking as the secret she's carrying.
She pointed one perfect blood-red nail at Annie Lee's heart.
Here's my advice for you, Annie Lee Keys. Get the hell out of Nashville while you still can.
Annie Lee finds comfort in a retired country music icon named Ruthanna, read in the audiobook by who else? Dolly herself.
Annie Lee swallowed. Pardon me?
It's a hard, rough business. A tiny thing like you, you'll be chewed up and spit out like a hunk of gristle.
I'm hoping to get to play that character when we do a movie of the book, which we hope to do at some point.
The book is, in a lot of ways, sort of a cautionary tale about the music business.
Mm-hmm. It is. It shows a lot of the dark side of it that people that have been in it, like me, you know that because you've lived it.
And did you experience a lot of that?
Oh, yeah, you see all that. All the managers, the people that rip you off, that try to steal your songs, they'll con you, they do whatever. I have seen it all.
She was a reservoir of country music research for Patterson, but as it's been all her life, Dolly doesn't enter in anything just to do it halfway.
If I take on a job or partnership with somebody, I'm going to do my part. I mean, how would I have been able to promote that book if I did not have some involvement? How would I have allowed that? Because if people asked me, I'd have felt like the biggest liar in the world. Put on my jeans, my favorite shirt.
Instead of just writing dialogue or helping block out chapters, Dolly added this.
Did they come to you pretty easily?
Oh, yeah, songs come to me easy, especially if I know what I'm writing about.
Patterson's characters were shaped by lyrics that Dolly wrote herself.
Is it easy? No, it ain't. Can I fix it? No, I can't. But I sure ain't gonna take it lying down.
A couple days after I got there, she sent me the lyrics for 7 songs.
Just a couple days?
Yeah.
He wrote 7 songs in a couple days?
Yeah.
Well, he would send me pages, and I would get ideas for the songs. And all of a sudden, it was like, ta-da, you write songs. He writes books. And so I just started doing it, not thinking about anything.
Big dreams and faded jeans fit together like a team. Always busting at the seams. Big dreams.
The album of Dolly's 12 original songs will be released this week in tandem with the novel. That's a rarity. Writing is where Parton and Patterson are more alike than you might think. It isn't a chore for either of them. It's as much a joy as it is a necessity.
Are you still writing pretty much every day? I mean, are you sort
I
of
write
like...
all the time. Yeah? I'm always scribbling something down.
Do you just write things down on the back of envelopes?
Oh, I write on everything, anything. Chewing gum papers, Kleenex boxes. All writers do.
They do. Yeah.
Do you do the same thing?
Uh-huh.
You do.
Yeah, the thing I don't do anymore is I will not get up in the middle of the night and write stuff down.
Did you used to do
that? My belief is that if it's good, I'll remember it. There's too many times I get up in the morning and I look at it and I go like, what?
That's it? When you dreamed it, yeah, I've dreamed things, but I'm not lazy enough, like some people, to not get up.
They are both champions of literacy. Dolly's own father couldn't read, which is why she cherished every book that came into her house.
But I write a song about everything, so I go and call, books, books, I love books, the way they smell and feel and look. From my first glance, I was hooked on books, books, books. It's a little song for my kids.
Over the last 25 years plus, her imagination library has gifted more than 150 million books to kids under the age of 5. For his part, Patterson has quietly donated millions of dollars to school libraries as well as independent bookstores and more.
Only 45% of the kids in this country read at grade level.
Is that right?
Which is a disgrace.
So, two of the biggest names in their respective fields not only share a cause and a byline, but a lot of mutual respect.
Well, I learned he's better than I even hoped that he would be. Honestly, he's so smart, he's so cool, and he listens very well. You know, he accepts, he knows who's who, and he knows...
I know who's boss.
Dolly gave Patterson an autographed guitar for his birthday. He says he's never learned to play it, preferring instead to let his co-writer sing us off, as only a Nashville legend can.
How good is she?
She's awesome.
Yeah.